we're facing a real data dilemma. We're creating a lot more than we can store. What we do save is degrading with each passing generation. And the networking technology that we rely on uses way too much power. What if we could store every bit of our data on a media that is virtually indestructible, that can scale in ways that use a lot less energy? That's the vision that's driving us at Microsoft to radically rethink and invent new disruptive technologies in three key areas: storage, networking, and compute. Over a third of all the silent movies ever made no longer exist. Perhaps you've heard of the Universal Studios fire of 2008, when tens of thousands of master recordings of our greatest artists were lost. So the media industry tell us that the films, music, the content that they produce is the value of their companies. And they go to extreme lengths to try to maintain it. And yet they acknowledge, even with their best efforts, everything is slowly degrading over time. And we hear that from other industries too. Like the banking sector, they understand exactly how risky current storage can be, how everything has to be backed up on a systematic basis, and the potential loss of critical data, that's enough to keep them up at night. On a more personal note, think of all the precious data that you carry around on your phone. All of that is just a mishap away from being lost. This is going to change all that forever. This is a platter of silica. Basically, it's a bit of glass. And it probably looks invisible to you. But if you look at it very carefully, you can see data that is stored inside it. If you think of the hard disk drive industry, it took them over 40 years to reach their platter capacity. And it took the optical disk industry over 25 years to reach the capacity that they're at today. We've been pushing on this technology for only 3 years. And already in this piece of glass, we can store more data than you store in an optical disk. And we're only just at the beginning. A piece of glass like this, theoretically, can store hundreds of terabytes of data. At Microsoft, we've been working hard at optimizing our cloud scale storage using existing technologies like hard disk drives and like tape. But we've got to the stage where we just can't push it as far as we want. And that led us to go out and look for a new media. Our search led us to Southampton University. They were writing data into glass using pulsed femtosecond lasers. These are lasers that are firing extremely short pulses of light into the piece of glass. And where that laser hit in the glass, a small dot was created. And that dot can store data. And we call that a voxel. And think of it like an iceberg. It's got depth and it's got orientation. And we're able to control both the orientation and the depth of the iceberg. And that's how we can store multiple bits in a single voxel. We just thought this was amazing. And we thought, how can we tame this technology to provide a storage system which doesn't require us to keep copying data from one generation to the next? It turns out that glass is remarkably resilient. You can boil this in water. You can scrub it with steel wool. You can subject it to electric magnetic pulses. You can even broil this at 500 degrees Fahrenheit. The data, once it's written inside of it, is gonna survive all those things. It is truly one of the most resilient media that has ever been found. Once you store your data in this, the data is gonna be there for 100, 1,000, even 10,000 years. And if you no longer want to keep your data, it's really simple. You can just melt it down and it becomes more glass. We've just heard about data storage as one of the challenges when we're thinking about the future. The other one is sustainable networking. It's about the energy and the speed with which we can transfer data over the network to access that storage. And in our team, we're working very hard at looking at new optical technologies that we can bring to bear on optical networking. If you think of a traditional data center at the moment, when you send some data, it goes from a server in a rack to a top-of-rack switch. That top-of-rack switch converts the data from electrons to photons and sends it to another switch, where it's converted back so that this can then decide where to send it next. And this process is then repeated millions of times across the data center. That means we're wasting huge amounts of energy doing these conversions. So what we're hoping to do is allow you to convert it just once, and then whoosh, we're going to send it across the entire network as light. And one way to think about all this is to think of this prism. If you shine sunlight into it, it's going to split the sunlight up into different colors. And this property is going to allow us to steer where the data goes. But the challenge is to do that really fast. When I say really fast, I mean light speed fast. So we went all in to create an optical chip that could switch between the different light colors at the nanosecond range. As for sustainability, every time we convert from photons to electrons and electrons to photons, it takes energy. So the great thing about this new optical networking is that the core is completely passive. All that happens is that it steers beams of light. It requires no additional energy to do that. We're trying to also incorporate it with optical storage to create new types of data centers that we can deploy in the most arid or icebound regions, out at sea, or even underwater. So most recently at Microsoft, we've been applying the same kind of radical thinking to compute. There are a lot of optical technologies, like 4K and 8K cameras, like SLMs, which are basically screens. They're all becoming mainstream now. And we're beginning to ask, are there things that have been explored in the past that might make sense now when we have these newer components? One of the things that we're really interested in doing is looking at whether we can create new machine learning algorithms that can be designed from the ground up to work with the kind of operations that you can do easily in the optical compute world. We're seeing a future where we can bring all of these technologies together. We're not there yet, but every day we're making progress on that dream. If you think of all the things that we've lost to time, the Library of Alexandria, the manuscripts of Da Vinci, irreplaceable writings and artistic masterpieces. Imagine if we could promise for you to store anything that's important to you, your emails, your documents, your photos, forever. For me, on here, I'm storing my wedding photos. So my great, 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 great grandchildren can enjoy them. It's really quite powerful to be able to store your information forever. It's going to change the way that we look at the past. It's going to change the way that we collaborate in the future. It is literally going to transform existence as we know it. Now, how powerful is that?